This video explains air temperature measurement, its associated problem and error, and the method to rectify it. And we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solution for EASA ATPL question and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comment section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. The value of air temperature is one of the basic parameters required to measure the performance monitoring of an aircraft. The air temperature data that is required is the air temperature under static condition. However, to measure it directly is not possible due to adiabatic compression and friction heating. The boundary layer surrounding the aircraft slows down or even stops near the surface of the aircraft. This in turn results in adiabatic compression, which increases the air temperature surrounding the aircraft. Furthermore, the friction between skin of the aircraft and the air particle also contributed to the rise in air temperature. The rise in air temperature surrounding the aircraft is known as ramp rise. Errors associated with air temperature sensor are heating, instrument, and environmental. We already discussed heating error in previous scene. Instrument error is error due to imperfection in manufacturing process. Environmental error is due to solar heating of temperature probe or ice accretion on the probe. The effect of ramp rise on air temperature can be summarized into a graph. The vertical axis represents temperature and the horizontal axis represents true airspeed. The temperature of undisturbed air is known as static air temperature or SAT and represented as green line on the graph. This is the temperature that we want to measure. However, heating due to adiabatic compression and friction will cause temperature to rise around the aircraft. This effect is represented on the graph by the red line. The resulting temperature is known as total air temperature or TAT. The difference between static air temperature and total air temperature is known as total ramp rise. As you can see, the amount of total ramp rise increases as the speed of the aircraft increases. Due to inefficiency of temperature sensor, we cannot fully measure the total ramp rise. This inefficiency is due to instrument and environmental error. The temperature that is indicated by aircraft temperature sensor is known as ramp air temperature or RAT. The difference between ramp air temperature and static air temperature is known as measured ramp rise. The ratio between measured ramp rise and total ramp rise give the recovery factor and written as K subscript R. The recovery factor is usually around 0.9 or 90%. Static air temperature is the temperature of undisturbed air which aircraft about to fly. Outside air temperature is the same as static air temperature. Total air temperature is the maximum air temperature attainable and can be summarized into formula where total air temperature equal to static air temperature plus total ramp rise. Ramp air temperature is the measured or indicated air temperature by air temperature measurement system. Solving air temperature problem. The first method to solve air temperature problem is by using rapid formula. The formula is ramp rise equal to V over 100 square. This method can be used during actual flight. However, this method could not be used during examination because it will only produce rough answer. The second method is by using the table given in the flight manual. On the screen is the sample temperature correction table for Boeing 737. To use this table, on top of the column is the Mach number that the aircraft fly. On the left column is the value of total air temperature registered on the instrument. For example, Let's see, the aircraft fly at 0.82 Mach and the temperature gauge indicates total air temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. The intersection between these two values is static air temperature and it is minus 15 degrees Celsius. However, this method could not be used in the examination unless you were supplied with the temperature correction table. The third method is by using CRP5 flight computer. On the computer face of CRP5, you can find blue arc labeled temperature rise. To use this scale, just find where your current true airspeed are and read the temperature rise on its opposite. For example, if your current true airspeed are 300 knots, the ramp rise is 9.5 degrees Celsius. This method can be used during the examination and it is the fastest way to solve air temperature measurement problem. The last method is by using the accurate formula. Static air temperature equal to TAT over 1 plus 0.2 recovery factor Mach square. Temperature value in this formula is in unit Kelvin. This formula will give the most accurate answer. It is advisable to use this formula during examination if the margin between the answer is close instead of using CRP5 temperature rise scale. Example, given total air temperature equal to minus 20 degrees Celsius, Mach number equal to 0.73, recovery factor equal to 0.98. What is the static air temperature? First, convert total air temperature into Kelvin. To convert from degrees Celsius to Kelvin, K equal to degrees Celsius plus 273. TAT in Kelvin equal to minus 20 plus 273 equal to 253 Kelvin. Now we substitute all the value into the formula. Static air temperature equal to total air temperature over 1 plus 0.2 recovery factor Mach number square. ACAT equal to 253 over 1 plus 0.2 times 0.98 times 0.73 squared. Static air temperature equal to 229 Kelvin. To convert from Kelvin to degree Celsius equal to Kelvin minus 273. Static air temperature in degree Celsius equal to 229 minus 273. The answer will be minus 44 degrees Celsius. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icon. Also, if you have any question or comment about any ATPL or aviation related question, you can leave them in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.